Hey guys, welcome back to another beer review behind the bar. I believe we're on beer review number 13. You may notice it's a little crowded on the bar tonight. I had to change the camera angle a little bit to get this to work right. Tonight I'm gonna do something a little different. We're gonna do a blind taste test. I love dinner and I love King Sue, and I was gonna kind of do a re-review of King Sue because I'd had the last batch and did a review of that, but Mike, the head brewer of Toppling Goliath that had left, came back, and this is his first batch of King Sue since coming back, and everybody says that it's back to what it was before, and it's better than ever, and incredible, and whatever. So I was going to do a re-review, but I thought, you know, let's see how it compares to my favorite double IPA, which is Dinner, maybe my favorite beer, period. And I wanted to do a blind test to see what I thought, to see if I could pick out which one was which and which one I liked the best. So we're gonna do that tonight. I had a little help. I don't know which is in which glass. I have a piece of paper on the bar here that I haven't looked in, haven't opened, that tells me which glass. As you can see, there are two different glasses, an Ursa Major glass from McCoy's and a Casey glass from Casey Brewing and Blending out in Colorado. So I don't know which is which. So we're gonna kinda wing it, see what I think of both beers, and then we'll kinda go from there and see if I guess right, and maybe King Sue will be my new favorite beer and I won't know it and I'll think it's Dinner. So who knows, but that's what we're gonna do. And yeah, so let's get started. If not, this video will take forever. So we'll start here on my right, and with the Ursa Major glass. Great color on this. Kind of a that tangerine-y juice, kind of. It's more orangey than yellow. These were poured a few minutes ago, so not a lot of head retention left there, but I mean, you know, decent lacing on the glass, good big suppy bubbles, but the head on this one, the head on that one's actually staying a little better. Yeah, so let's see what it smells like. Yeah, great smelling beer. It's mango, just freaking mango for days is what I'm getting on this. Mango, oranges, a little pineapple, but definitely, I'm not getting any, alcohol in the nose or anything like that. No parts of, the malt backbone or anything like that. It's just all hot, punch you in the face. Citrus, mango, though. Overriped, juicy, squeeze it, mango. Smells delicious. This beer is a little bit more yellow, more of, a straw kind of color, just juice. Pineapple juice-ish, but yeah, beautiful beer. This one, on the other hand, is a little bit more, it's a little bigger nose. Definitely more pineapple in this one, more orange, no mango what's to speak of, more peach, but no breadiness from the malt, This beer smells incredible. Can we talk about, just for 5 seconds, I love Citra hops. They're both Citra hop beers. I know that, I believe Dinner has other hops in it as well. This is just a huge double Citra hopped beer. King Sue is. It's basically pseudo Sue on steroids. I love Citra. I go bathe in water, just soaking Citra. It's so good. Anyway, so both great smelling beers. We'll go ahead and dig in though. Gotta cheers these. Yeah, so cheers. Let's see what we think. Yeah, the mango carries through for me, with an added peachiness. I'm definitely getting some peaches in there. And the mango, a little orange, a little pineapple. That's good. No real maltiness to speak of. I mean, I'm getting a little bit of probably two row that's kind of backing that up. It's got a dankness to it though that's kind of sticking with me. It's I feel like it's on my teeth. Not overly hot bomb bitterness like a stone beer, but it's got, I can just, it's like a tropical fruit dankness that's just sticking with me. A little bitter, but it finishes and just kind of goes away. But freaking great beer. God, it's good. That is really good. Yeah, biggest mistake that I'm just realizing is that I didn't bring water to wash. I got some club soda, but I don't think that would work very well to wash in between. So I'll just kind of wait for a sec, but whatever it is, not getting any alcohol on this. I mean, they're both double IPAs, you know, bigger ABVs, but I'm not picking up any of the alcohol at all. Just as these beers are with this New England style and Toppling Goliath's kind of doing it as well, that, you know, not a ton of malt backbone. It's the hops that these beers are all out, and then mouthfeel. This has a good mouthfeel. It's not overly creamy like Eric and Joe and I, other beer reviewers on YouTube, have been, you know, all about Treehouse beers and the Trillium that had these mouthfeels like creamy, like these, that beer didn't have that, but it's still like, it's more of a West Coast mouthfeel, but it's not, on the hop standpoint, it's not bittering at all. It's not overly bittering. It's just pop citrus. So anyways, enough of me talking. Let's try number two. Cheers. Oh, fuck. I love beer, guys. Like, and I know I do a lot of IPAs on the channel, and it's just because it's kind of the season right now, and I'll do more stouts and porters and October style beers as we get into fall. But they're so good. Like, this is killer. Like, this beer. I sure hope I'm right on which one I think is which, because that would be embarrassing at this point, because they're both phenomenal. This one, a little creamier mouthfeel, a little bit more carbonation. I get like a little more carbonation I'm feeling, like tingling on my tongue, and then maybe the hops though. But no, again, no malt backbone. Just huge pineapple and huge, like, little orange, like pineapple. Little bit of peach. There's definitely some peach there. Oh, speaking of bathing into drops, I would bathe in this beer. I'd smell horrible for everyone else, but this would be incredible. So good. So I'm pretty sure I know which one's which. I'm guessing this is dinner, because I mean, if I'm reviewing right now and rating on the fly, I'm re-reviewing this. I don't remember what I gave this the first time. I should have looked. I'm assuming 98.99, somewhere in there, probably. A 99 for sure. I mean, it's definitely, if I'm right, it's definitely better than the last batch. It's definitely fuller. It's definitely more flavorful throughout than the last one. I thought that the last version of King's Sioux had basically zero on the nose. Like, it, you could smell citrus, but it wasn't poppy at all. And this is definitely more poppy as far as pop, like, aroma. And then this is, it's 100. I mean, it's still going to stay as my favorite beer. Outside of Curiosity 18 from Treehouse, got me confused for a few weeks and I thought it was the best, but going back to this. Let's hope I'm right though, or this is going to be really embarrassing. thank the Lord. Casey Glass, which would be this one, is Dinner, and the Ursa Major Glass is King Sioux. So I was right. Thank goodness, because that would have been really embarrassing. I've been worried about this review for like 3 days. Ask people that have talked to me. That's it, guys. I wanted to do something different with the channel. Everybody does beer reviews. I'm trying to do stuff a little creative. We're gonna have some guest spots coming up. I have a couple planned right now. People that you know, that you talk to on Beer Tasting Kansas City and other websites and see in public, we're gonna do beer reviews with them. We may do some out at breweries as well. I've got a couple things lined up, so that's gonna be fun. So subscribe. Not because I want subscribers, just because it's fun to talk to other beer people on more than just Facebook. The comments, I respond to all the comments on YouTube and anything else, so it's the best part of it. So if you don't have a YouTube account and just keep watching, that's great too. But if you do, sign up, subscribe, and we will keep chatting and keep watching the beer reviews. I'm trying to do more. I'm glad that I got this one right. Thanks for watching again, and this was fun. So see you again next time from behind the bar. Cheers, guys.